G'day, you bloating legends. Welcome back to another video on the channel. I'm your host, Sid, on the Aussie Mate 29 YouTube channel. And today, I am doing my first cover of the World of Warships Legends patch notes. Let's dive into it, shall we? So, let's just cover the maintenance times real quick. If you're on Xbox, it can take place between 2 to 6 a.m. Central Time and / 7 to 11 a.m. Just to tell you, I butchered that pretty badly, so. If you just want to have a look at this, it'll stay right here on the screen for you. So just pause the video if you want to take a look at that. Now, update size. This is why that's why it gets a bit dicey. So, on Xbox One, Series X, it will be 2,150 megabytes. Xbox One, Series X. Xbox Series X, 2,200 megabytes. PlayStation 4, 2,093 megabytes. PS5, 471 megabytes. That's no big surprise because, again, they're all brand new. iOS is 1,000 megabytes plus, so you'll be looking at 1,496 megabytes for both. For Android, it'll be up to around 1,200 megabytes. Now, over the wings. Wings over waves. And this is where we're going to be seeing stuff. So, obviously, if you know in the trailer, we have a new campaign ship coming our way. And it's a Dutch cruiser with airstrikes. So, we're starting to get some of the airstrike mechanics over from the PC version. And also the carriers. They're getting a massive rework. Can't wait to see what they're going to be like once they do get buffed and reworked. And then we have a soccer event by the looks, and we have a D-Day event. Okay, let me read this for you. Didn't mean to highlight that. Captain, summer has finally arrived. While here in Australia, we are approaching winter, and a wave of new adventures and fresh experiences await you in this update. Before you dive in, be sure to equip yourself for the battle ahead. Redeem the code, as you can see. I'll zoom in on the code on the screen, so you can definitely have a good look at it, and pause the video to have a look at it. To receive one summer big crate, 5 European camos, and 5 Type 4 camos. Here's a quick rundown of what's new in this update. Sky Reaper from the Lowlands campaign featuring ancient Dutch Tier 7 cruiser D7. I cannot pronounce that because my Dutch is absolutely terrible with the new airstrike armament. Will we be seeing more in the near future? Hopefully. But it's starting to get some of the PC mechanics coming over here at the Legends. The D-Day anniversary. Obviously, you know about the Normandy invasions during World War II. We're going to see a lot of camos coming in the anniversary of D-Day. Now, revised carriers. So, carriers are getting a massive rework to how they operate. So, they are going to get a massive balance to the carriers. So, such as restoration times, more bombs, less damage, just to balance everything out. And then we have this event that is coming up. I'll be interested to play that. Popular collaborations returning in the store. That's going to be interesting. I'm going to have to look in the store for that. I'll be planning to stream when this update does come out, so stay tuned for that. New Brawl, Seasons, and Fleet Battles. So Fleet Battles make a return in this update. I'm not really surprised about Brawl. Brawl isn't my cup of tea, but it might be your cup of tea. But I'm very interested to see Fleet Battles if I can get my fleet... If I can get most of my fleet members online, that is. Pray for me for that and more. Sky Reaper from the Lowlands campaign. Okay, and this is the Tier 7 Dutch cruiser. And I have to say, it's not too shabby at all. It actually looks quite nice. It looks like something from the 50s at least. it actually looks pretty good, especially that radar dome. It could be from the Korea War era, but could be wrong. So, let's cover this. This new campaign features the Dutch Tier 7 cruiser. Again, I'm not going to pronounce it because my Dutch is terrible. The first ship of newly added nation, the Netherlands. Woo! Netherlands! With her powerful airstrike weaponry and impressive fire-setting capabilities, she will instill fear in your enemies. The campaign compresses of 100 milestones spread over 5 weeks, with the catch-up mechanic enabled to assist any players who fell behind. You can complete the missions in both versus AI mode and standard battles. We are also introducing a new historical Dutch commander, Kirill Dorman. He'll join your ranks automatically as soon as you receive the final reward of the campaign. Kirill Dorman's unique base trait, Stop at Any Cost, improves damage and shell grouping against cruisers and destroyers up to 3%. That's not too shabby. That means this thing's gonna be a destroyer killer. Can't wait to see this out in the water. Let's take a look at the campaign rewards without the Admiralty backing. So I'm going to, again, zoom in on screen so you can definitely take a look of what's gonna be here. And it'll stay right here on the screen for you. Now moving on from that, available rewards without the Admiralty backing is all this. Again, I'll pause the video now so you can have a look at all this. Okay, you finished looking? Great. Now, the value rewards without the Admiralty backing is 13,543 doubloons, not too shabby. Additional rewards with Admiralty backing is 2,500 doubloons. That is actually not too shabby either. And this is with the Admiralty backing. Again, pause the video so you can have a look, and it'll stay here on the screen for you. Now moving on, D-Day 80th anniversary. Geez, the year's been quick. So, let me read this out for you so you don't have to. To commemorate the 80th anniversary of the Normandy landings, also known as D-Day, we've prepared plenty of themed new content. Complete dedicated missions starting from May 27th to earn collectible D-Day cards, which provide compelling information about D-Day warships, the Normandy landings, and military decorations. Collect all these cards to receive the final prize, French Tier 3 Battleship Corvette 1944, with a special D-Day permanent camo that includes a counter for enemy ships sunk. Now that's actually quite good, despite the fact I do not play Tier 3 anymore. That's actually pretty good looking. But I have a funny feeling that the guns, because it's French, it's going to be trolley. But it's to be expected because it's Tier 3. Not mean to absolutely dumpster on Tier 3, though. It's still unique to have those type of ships down at Tier 3. Moreover, several heroic ships that participated in the Normandy landings will await you in the store during this event. These include new Commonwealth Tier 7 Evan Destroyer Haida in her Thimic Permanent Camo Camouflage with a counter for defeated ships, along with Texas Warships by Belfast, I cannot pronunciate that because it's Polish, and Arkansas. These ships will be available in special bundles that also grant access to unique missions. Additionally, don't miss a dedicated mission for Nevada that will bring you a D-Day permanent camouflage for her, also featuring a counter for enemy defeats. Now, not too shabby. Not too shabby. And stay tuned for upcoming dedicated article to learn more about the event missions and rewards. Now, here comes the bread and butter. The aircraft carrier revised. And we're getting towards the end, guys. So hopefully you still have a nice set of popcorn, whatever you're doing. Before I do read this article, make sure you do consider leaving a thumbs up and consider subscribing. That would definitely help out the channel a lot. And also share this video. It really helps me out a lot to make videos for you boarding legends. Now, back to the video. In this in this June update, we find aircraft carriers to make them better suited for any type of battle. This includes air spotting changes, an enlarged hangar with reduced restoration time for planes, new plane fuel mechanisms, an increased number of bombs dropped though with reduced damage per hit, and more tweaks. Additionally, starting from the update, plane costs have been reduced to zero, and there are slight changes to their economic balance. Read our traditional mystery of balance article dropping tomorrow to explore the complete list of changes. So, the fuel mechanism, that's got to be interesting to have. The nice fuel mechanics. So that means your planes can't essentially stay up in the air for too long. So if you're like one of those carrier players that do want to keep your planes up to spot a destroyer, you have a time limit to how long your plane squadron can remain in the air before you have to go turn around to the carrier and refuel. So that would be interesting. At least that this is going to balance out the carriers. More bomb, an increased number of bombs. Very interesting indeed. And to reduce damage per hit. That's even better. Because if you drop multiple bombs on one player and they don't have reduced damage, in my opinion, that's considered broken. Now to the second part of the article. To try out the new mechanics on top-notch vessels, you can rent aircraft carriers Haraku, Midway, Edge, and Grav Zeppelin in the store for credits during this update. They'll be yours to play for 14 days, so that's 2 weeks. After that, they'll disappear from your list of ships and will no longer be available to rent. If you purchase any of these aircraft carriers before or May 27th, they will remain available to you as well. Please note that we are removing aircraft carriers for sale, for the duration of this update, before returning them to the store in upcoming versions. We may make a few adjustments based how well the balance changes perform, and of course, yours truly, your feedback. Hey, at least that we're going to be having the ability to test carriers with the cost of credits. But in my opinion, having legendary tier carriers up for grabs, it's kind of, yeah, but it's only just because of low tier carry players, that's the thing I'm scared of. But I think that I would actually like to play Midway, despite the fact of how many of the people I've played with on Legends say how garbage Midway is, but this might actually make Midway better. Like, you know, if you just watch the channel, I don't play carriers, I only play battleships. And now, to this. So, let's celebrate the most exciting days of Europe football. Together, score goals during the Qatar Championship for our new web event starting June 10. To receive rewards patches representing 24 European soccer teams, soccer-inspired consumable camp, camouflage, a new sporty permanent camo for Fiji, and more soon. We will release an article where you can link for the championship and check out all of the rules. And Warhammer 40k collab returns to Legends. Most say you think I do. So, Warhammer 40k X Legend collaboration is back in the store. Explore warring factions of the far future and power up your forces with inspired commanders, ships, crates, and more in game. Items available in the store from May 27th through July 1st. We've also employed several balance changes to theme ships and commander. So Ragnarok's getting buffed, that hunky dunky thing's getting buffed. To Arthas the Cold. That is going to hurt for those that have inspirations. If you have Arthas as an inspiration for your battleships, it's going to get even better. And Justinian Lions, I don't have it, but it's pretty cool for what I've heard from many players. Arthas the Cold is really good if you have him as an inspiration for your battleship players, for your battleship commanders. Transformers Gun Legendary. Transformers content is available in the store again. Choose to fight for Autobot or the Defense by equipping yourself with a medic in-game items, commander ship skins, crates and flags, etc. The thematic content will be available in the store from June 3rd through July 1st. Okay, now I'm going to be covering the Brawl fleet seasons, and then we're going to wrap it up with the improvements and bug fixes. So, two Brawl seasons await you in this update. During Season 19, you'll be playing Tier 6 battleships with increased movement speed, significantly buffed main battery guns, and nerfed shell dispersion and grouping. Season 20 features battles with Tier 5 cruisers that have boosted main stats, including damage from main gun shells and movement speed. Fleet battles turns again. Fleet battles are finally back. We are rerunning the test season, but this time it's all tier 6 ships, and divisions can be led into battle by members with the officer role. Complete against other fleets in 5-player divisions, enjoy the team spirit, and earn rewards such as the unique fleet tranquilizer flag, steel, and more. Fleet battles are available for console players every Wednesday, Saturday, and Sunday during this update. So if you are looking for steel to grind for this update, go for fleet battles. If you are looking at getting the Mighty Missouri, getting the new Tier 8 Japanese battleship that came in the store, or even the Salem if you want to, that's a good opportunity for you. Now, time to cover this, and then we are going to wrap it up there. Improvements and bug fixes. Check out the improvements and fixes coming in this update. So, this is for all platforms, and I'm only going to read the console ones, since reasons. The Netherlands has been added as a standard nation for ships and commanders. Fleet 8 members with the officer role can now lead fleet divisions into battle. After completing collection, any additional cards will be converted into 2,500 credits each. Research progress in old bureau projects can now be boosted using research points. Yes! Now I can finally boost my Worcester. Fixed a bug that caused some players to not receive rewards for event missions. Fixed a issue where information about medals held didn't update immediately in the server's record. Now, I find that pretty awkward because every single time I look back at my medals, I always see that they've not updated instantly, which always annoyed me. Anyways, that's going to wrap it up for this, you Boarding Legends. If you did enjoy, make sure you do consider a thumbs up and consider subscribing for another video coming your way. See you in the next one, you Boarding Legends.